Hi everyone, welcome back. In today's session, we are going to read and understand Unit 5, Reading C, which is titled as A Tale of Three Villages. The meaning of tale is story, the story of three villages. So, Reading C contains the stories of three villages. And in today's session, we are going to read the first village, which is named as Koko Village in Nigeria. Let's begin it. Mr. Sunday Nana, his wife and four small children live in Koko Village, Nigeria. The village is like any other African village, picturesque, colorful and noisy. The Nana family's house too is the same as all the other houses in the village, with the mud walls and a rusting corrugated iron roof, and with the children and chickens sharing the same compound. Let's discuss and learn some important words that are present in the paragraph. The first one, picturesque. The meaning of picturesque is charming, beautiful, visually attractive. Fine. Now, the meaning of rusting is becoming covered with rust. Becoming covered with rust. Corrugated is shaped into a series of regular waves. Now, Mr. Sunday Nana, his wife and four small children live in village, Koko Village, which is in Nigeria. Where do they live? Mr. Sunday Nana, his wife and four children live in a village named Koko Village, which is in Nigeria. Fine. The village is like any other African village, picturesque, colorful and noisy. Like any other village in the Africa, Koko Village was also very colorful, very noisy and very picturesque, very attractive, very beautiful. Right? Now, the Nana family's house too is the same as all other houses in the village. Now, what does it mean? Like any other houses in the village of Africa, you know, the same, like the Nana's family's house was also made of, or you know, built with the mud and rusting corrugated iron roof. Fine. And the children and chickens were sharing the same compound. Do you understand? There is one difference, however. Outside Mr. Nana's front are three large empty metal drums, the bright red paint now flaking away, but the skull and crossbone symbol clearly visible on each. And in a clearing 200 meters away from the village, next to a stream that the villagers get their drinking water from, is an enormous pyramid of identical drums reaching to the sky. Let's see some of the words. The meaning of flaking is, you know, breaking as thin small pieces, breaking into pieces. Now, skull and crossbones. Skull and crossbones. It symbolizes that, you know, something is dangerous. The symbol of skull and crossbone, it shows that something is dangerous. Now, enormous is, you know, big, huge. So even though Mr. Sunday Nana's house was like any other houses in the villages of Africa, but there was one difference. Now what is the difference? Outside Mr. Nana's house, there were three large empty metal drums. There were three large empty metal drums. The bright red paint now flaking away. The red paint is now, you know, flaking away, breaking as thin pieces. But the skull and crossbone symbols clearly visible on each. Do you understand? Even though the color is fading away, but the skull and crossbone symbol, which is, you know, which is on the metal drums, are very clearly seen. Simple, in front of Mr. Sunday Nana's house, there are three large empty metal drums which are fading in color, but the skull and crossbone symbols that are there on the drums are very visible. Do you understand? And in a clearing 200 meters away from the village, next to a stream that the villagers get their drinking water from is an enormous pyramid of identical drums reaching to the sky. So there are three empty drums, or you know, empty metal drums in front of Nana's house, and again there are two identical pyramids near the stream. They are almost like reaching the sky, and the people get their drinking water. Do you understand? The villagers get their drinking water from the stream, right? Now, next to the stream, there is an enormous huge pyramid of identical drums, which are very similar in appearance. There are two, or you know, there is an enormous pyramid of identical drums. They're almost like reaching the sky. Some of them are badly corroded. Their slimy contents of various colors, gray, dark green, bright orange, etc., leaking out down onto the baked African earth and into the stream. Some have fallen down and rolled, or been rolled by playful children, into the bush. Some are smoking in the midday heat. Some are swelling as if their contents are bursting to get out. Some have already burst. Now, what is meant by corroded? The meaning of corroded is rusted. Leaking out is, you know, being released or get out, break. Swelling, the condition of being larger or rounder than normal. It's, you know, more than normal. Some of them are badly corroded. Now, what is referring here? Them, these are, you know, drums. These drums are badly rusted. Their slimy contents of various colors. What does it contain? Various colors. What are those colors? Gray, dark green, bright orange, etc. Leaking out down onto the baked African earth and into the stream. So these various colors were leaking out. They were released from these drums, and they were flowing to the earth, flowing onto the earth, and they were getting into the stream. They were getting mixed up with the water. Do you understand? Some have fallen down and rolled, or been rolled by playful children, into the bushes. It's a clear, right? Some drums have been rolled by themselves, and some have been, you know, brought down or rolled by some playful children, and they were brought or thrown into the bushes. Some are smoking into the midday heat. It doesn't mean that, you know, the drums are smoking, but because of the heat and the contents that are present in the drums, because of this, there was a smoke coming out of the drums. So please understand, drums are not smoking. Clear? Some are swelling as if their contents are bursting to get out. Swelling is, you know, to become larger or rounder than normal. They were become, you know, bulging like. They were bulging out as if they are going to burst out. And already some have burst out. So students, please understand here, Mr. Sunday Nana is narrating what actually happened in his village. Okay, fine. Now, they came on a Wednesday, said Sunday. Many, many big lorries. They took all day unloading them. No one told us what was in them. They gave the chief a brown paper bag. I saw him smiling as the lorries drew away. This was 5 years ago. So one fine Wednesday, what happened? Mr. Sunday Nana says, many, many big lorries came, and they took all day unloading them. Now, what is meant by unloading? Remove goods from a vehicle, here from lorries. So they took all the day unloading those metal drums. Do you understand metal drums? Previous slide we have seen those metal drums were swelling. They were like almost like getting, you know, to burst out, and there was a various colors leaking out. Okay, those drums were brought by those lorries. So the lorries took almost whole day to unload them. and nobody told about those metal drums to the villagers of Coco. They gave the chief a brown paper bag. I saw him smiling as the lordess drew away. Do you understand? So, a brown paper bag was given to the chief. This chief could be the in charge or, you know, the head of the village. He was given a brown paper bag. Could be a bribe, could be some, you know, money that was in the paper bag. And Sunday Nana saw him smiling as he was receiving the brown paper bag, and the lorries drew away. And this happened 5 years ago. Do you understand? So those metal drums were not actually from their village. They were brought from elsewhere. Then 3 months ago, one of the brightest boys in the village, Thomas Ogonio, started university in Lagos. He came home one weekend with a new chemistry book and spent all day looking at the drums and writing things down and talking to himself and shaking his head. So what does Mr. Sunday Nana say? He says that, you know, 3 months ago, one of the brightest boys in the village, what is his name? Thomas Ogonio. He started, you know, university in Lagos, and when he came home one weekend, he came with a new chemistry book. He brought a new chemistry book with him when he came home at the weekend, and he spent all the day looking at the drums and writing things down. He was looking at the drums and he was writing things down and talking to himself and shaking his head. Do you understand? We all thought he had gone mad. Then he called a meeting of the village and told us that the drums contained poisonous chemicals. He said they had come from Italy, but I don't know where that is. Is it in Europe? We all thought he had gone mad. Why people thought he had gone mad? Who is referring he here? It is Thomas Ogonio, who is studying in the university, right? So when he came at the weekend, he brought a chemistry book with him. He was looking at the drums, he was writing something down, and he was shaking his head and he was talking to himself. So when villagers saw this Thomas, everyone thought he went mad. But what happened? He called all the villagers and he told the villagers that the drums contained poisonous chemicals and they were brought from Italy. And Mr. Sunday Nana doesn't even know where Italy is. He asks, is it in Europe? Do you understand? Mr. Sunday Nana stopped frowning, a troubled look on his face. In the last 5 years, 13 people have died in this village, my own elder brother one of them. They have been in pain, terrible pain. We have never seen deaths like that before. What is meant by frowning? It's, you know, bringing eyebrows together to show anger. So when Thomas Ogonio says that, you know, the drums contain the poisonous chemicals, Mr. Sunday Nana, there was a frown on his face. There was a troubled look on his face. So he says, in last 5 years, 13 people have died in the village, and his brother was one among them. And the people, those who have died, were in great pain before their death. And the pain was terrible. And he says that they have never seen deaths like that before. Lots of our children are sick. We have asked the government to take the drums away, but they do nothing. We have returned to Italy, but they do nothing. The chief says we should move our houses to another place. It's a clear, right? So many people have died. Almost 13 people have died because of the poisonous gases that were leaked from the drums. And many of their children were sick. So they have asked the government to take the drums away, but they do nothing. And even they have returned, you know, to the Italy, but they also did nothing. And the chief, the in charge, the head of the village says that they should quit from that place and to find houses in another place. But we have no money to buy land. We have no choice. We have to stay here. And they, pointing to the mountain of death in the clearing, are our neighbors. So when the chief says that they have to move their houses or to find their houses elsewhere, the people of the village say that they have no money to buy the land to construct the house, so they have no other choice instead to remain in the same place, to stay there itself. So Mr. Sunday Nana says that pointing to the mountain of death. Do you understand? Within 5 years, 13 people have died. And if this continues, he knows the death rates will be increasing in number. So he says, pointing to the mountain of death in the clearing are our neighbors. Is it clear? Well, students, here we end reading C, A Tale of Three Villages. The first village, Cocoa Village, Nigeria. Let's do the summary of it. Mr. Sunday Nana, his wife and 4 children live in Cocoa Village, Nigeria. 5 years ago, the village was like any other African village, picturesque, colorful and noisy. But now, in a clearing 200 meters away from the village, next to a stream that the villagers get their drinking water from, is an enormous pyramid of identical drums reaching to the sky. The skull and crossbone symbol is clearly visible on each. Later, Thomas Ogonio, one of the brightest boys in the village, explained to the villagers that the drums contained poisonous chemicals and they had come from Italy. 13 people have died and lots of children were sick in the last 5 years because of those poisonous drums. I believe you have understood. See you in the next session to discuss about the second village.